Welcome back to another video. Today, my name is Nicholas. So let's jump right into the video.
By the uniqueness of your tactics, your adaptability, the agility of your minds.
And today I will be talking about shrinking rate. And before I start, just for those who don't know, shrinking rate in the comics is a full-on dude, and the one that you see in the animated series is a full-on female. The reasoning behind this was because of diversity, which I don't really consider that diversity. Anyway, let's move on to her first appearance in Invincible issue, well, his first appearance in Invincible issue 9 in February 2004. He died in Invincible issue 40, April 2007. He was created by Robert Kirkman, of course. Past and full name is not really have been elaborated on. Investigative reporters had a theory that they know Shrieking Ray's identity. It's stated that Ray was a microorganics in Bethra. I don't know how to pronounce it. I forgot how to pronounce it. It's somewhere around Maryland. During the time that the nanotech lab was destroyed, since he survived the destruction of the lab from an implosion, not to be confused with implosion. I think implosion is a lot bigger than an explosion. He was unable to be located after the implosion occurred. The reporters theorized Ray gained the ability of size altering from the incident, which led him to become the superhero Shrinking Ray. Ray will catch the attention of the world after defeating a microscopic assassin that was trying to kill a lieutenant governor from inside his brain. Several years later, Shrinking Ray continued to fight against crime. Ray was sent to invite was sent an invite to join the Guardians of the Globe, but was insecure about his powers. He would still continue his heroic deeds. Now let's move on to his powers and abilities. He of course has he can alter his size just like any other character who has this ability, like Ant-Man, Black Goliath, Atlas, Atom, etc. You get the point.